I'm an artist, comic artist, coming from Denmark. My name is Christian Neugaard. I've been doing comics all my life, I think. And I've mostly been doing comics international. I've not been very active in my own country doing comics, and mostly I've been working in the States, USA, and in France. I met Benny Böttger while I was working on children's books. Actually, I've done a lot of children's books next to my work as a comic book artist. That's a way to get a living in Denmark as an illustrator. You don't live just by doing comics. So I've done a lot of children's books, and Benny Böttger, he wrote one story I had to illustrate early on. And so once I got an opportunity from Glenar to come up with a horror story, I approached him again and told him, should we make some graphic novel together? And the fact that Benny Böttger is very much into horror comics, stories, heavy metal, and so on. So he just grabbed the opportunity, and we worked together. Mishugi started out as Glenar had a sort of imprint that was publishing strictly horror comics. It was called Flesh and Bones. And the whole imprint was printed in black and white. That was kind of the style. Black and white and gray tones. That was like the frame for how you did the comics. So that was actually the reason why it started out in black and white. But it fitted the story very well. And at some point, we abandoned the idea to have it as a part of this frame of stories. We just kept the black and white. It was fitting for the story. The story is very gothic and almost a Jack the Ripper like story, and with lots of dark shadows, sea lights, and film noir feeling. So I think that the black and white fitted the story very well, although it didn't start as an intention that way. But the graphic style of Mishugi, it's very much inspired by reality, of course. Placed in the story takes place in 1905 in Copenhagen. And it takes place in, of course, Copenhagen, which is a real place with real buildings. Some of them from that time still exists, as they almost were at that time. Some have, of course, been demolished or burned, but a lot of it is actually as you see it at that time. And the environment, there's one of the important places in the story is a ghetto which housed a lot of Jews persecuted during the pogroms in eastern countries. And that exact place has been demolished completely because it was bad buildings, poor people, and nothing to save there. So that place has completely been erased. So for that part of the story, I had to research a lot luckily for me, there's a website especially for Copenhagen things, circulated with photos where people can upload historical pictures from way back, and you can search in the database and find exactly. I can search for special street, and I can get all sorts of old pictures. I can see people's clothing and how they appear, and the buildings and the wagons, and so that was a real important thing to be able to recapture that period of time. So that, of course, inspired me a lot. Previously, I've been doing a story called Le Meurtre d'un Enfer, which is a historic historic fantasy, historical but with fantastic elements, taking place in the 16th century. And the recent story I did, Michoud, takes place in the last century, 1900s, and also with fantastic elements incorporated. So I certainly like to work in historical environments, and I don't know, in future projects that could maybe be an issue as well. I'm not sure what another setting should be, or a period. I'm maybe more interested in the story elements and the psychological aspects of the characters in and if their story takes me in, brings me in, then if it takes place in a Western environment, or a medieval environment, or the Stone Age, or maybe in the future, then it's okay. It's not so much the time and setting that's important for me. But yeah, but of course, it's hard to tell, because it's once you sit down and have to do the drawings and look at your research, and you find out if you have a feeling that this is interesting to draw, maybe some buildings that has some details that you just like to draw. It's hard to say actually what constitutes a special interesting setting. But I'm always open to new stories and new settings. So I don't know. Yeah. In the future, I would like to explore as well. Take a try at doing my own stories. Maybe it's still a little bit daunting to jump into this area. I find it very interesting. To write and make characters, but with so long being focusing on doing the drawings and doing the best you can do, doing the drawings, the best drawings, you sort of neglect the other side a bit, because and you get better at the drawings and you feel comfortable doing that, and suddenly the writing process feels a little bit, it's going into the deep water, and you think, I'm not good enough for that, I can't put words together, that's good enough. And but still I feel an urge in myself to at one point try to struggle with writing words and stories and plots and characters. So I don't know, maybe in the near future. Mm-hmm.